tutti e benvenuti alla presentazione del Ducati Team 2020. Benvenuti quindi nel cuore di Bologna, all'interno di questa meravigliosa cornice che è il Palazzo Re Enzo. Siamo quindi pronti per dare il via a quello che sarà un nuovo inizio, per guardare quindi con lo sguardo ben proiettato al nostro futuro, e lo facciamo in compagnia di coloro che tra poco saliranno su questo palco. Vediamo già le moto che tra poco verranno svelate. Saluto ovviamente tutti i presenti in questa sala e saluto anche coloro che da ogni angolo del mondo attraverso il live streaming ci stanno seguendo. Partiamo quindi da qua, da Bologna, dal centro, dal cuore pulsante della Motor Valley, e per dare inizio nel migliore dei modi a questa serata chiamo qua sul palco l'amministratore delegato di Ducati Motor Holding, Claudio Domenicali. Ciao Claudio, ben ritrovato. Siamo pronti per cominciare, a te quindi il palco, prego.
Bene, bravo. Benvenuti a tutti, è davvero un grande onore per me essere qui in questa bellissima sala per fare davvero il più grande in bocca al lupo ai nostri ragazzi che partono per questa altra stagione che ci auguriamo sia davvero appassionante e interessante come quella che abbiamo appena concluso. Siamo qui nel cuore della Motor Valley, veramente una regione straordinaria, una regione in cui nell'arco di 150 chilometri vede
150 kilometers or less than 95 miles there's a unique concentration of crazy and extraordinary brands. Well, especially if you like, I mean, the world's nicest cars and bikes, Ferrari, Maserati, Lamborghini, Dallara, Pagani, in terms of cars. And, of course, we have Ducati, so the two wheels from Borgo Panigale. This is a neighborhood just in the outskirts of Bologna, just a stone's throw from here. So it's nice and it's also iconic. I mean, we had to be here in this city because, you know, this is a challenge. And once again, what we want to do is to, you know, share some of our most beautiful values we have in this country around the world. Now, racing for Ducati is, once again, an extraordinarily important part of our company. So this is maybe the most advanced part of the research and development department here in Bologna. And once again, they very important investment. For example, just some maths. If you take into account the money we spent for the racing development department, plus what we do in terms of research and development for the rest of our products, well, this takes more than 10% of the turnover of the company. This is what we spend every year in research and development. R&D is one of the key factors if you really want to keep this company as competitive as possible, together with the so-called country system, which has to be as competitive as possible again. Once again, the company has to be a healthy one. But I'm sure that we also help this country, so this country can really be proud of, well, taking part, let's say, into this world global challenge, if you will. Now, Europe, our continent, has very important values, especially based on democracy and freedom. And it is, of course, undeniable that if you really want to protect this value, well, let's say that the economic independence of our nations is fundamental. And this is based on the financial independence of every single company and organization that we have here. So today we will be talking about sport, but we also talk about business, because, you know, Ducati is an organization. So I hope that, well, you can do what I will do. So we really, really have to wish good luck to the two riders that will be here in a few minutes. They will represent, let's say, results in terms of sports, but they also represent a beautiful part of this country. Once again, we spend money. There are so many investments. We do research and development, and once again, we are so proud of what we're doing here in this part of the country. Now, this is much more than, you know, the what we do. I mean, we do so many things here, much more than racing. Once again, passion. Passion is really one of the hallmarks of our brand. And, you know, Andrea and Danilo will be on our bikes in a racing track, or maybe we can be in a racing track. We can be just in front of our TV set. But all of this is extraordinary. So this is what we are doing, Ducati. Research plus technology plus science, without forgetting passion, emotion, an incredible teamwork, and once again, a human touch that we cannot forget. I need to thank many, many of you because you give us support, you give us assistance. I really would like to thank partners and sponsors who are here with us tonight. I mean, without you, it would be impossible to get the results that we have got. Don't forget, Ducati is the only company in Europe winning competitions in the MotoGP since the beginning of this championship. The first year was 2002. Only Japanese brand or Ducati managed to win competitions in the MotoGP. So all of this wouldn't have been possible without our own effort, but especially without the support and the assistance of you. I mean, many, many partners who, I mean, we can see here in this room. Thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to keep going. Now, this is an important organization here in Bologna, 1,600 staff. Our turnover is 700 million euros. Of course, we cannot compete against the Japanese giants without your support, without your assistance. Once again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much. Grazie for what you do for us. Well, thank you, Claudio. Now, of course, you talked about the Italian style, the Italian flavor, a brand that people know all over the world. You talk about wins and emotions. So why don't we dream, you know, about wins and emotions? I think that we have beautiful images, a beautiful picture from Austria, Mugello here in Italy, and Qatar. So we have a beautiful clip that I'd like you to enjoy. Well, I personally think that every single win, and here we've seen, I mean, three such wins with some specific, you know, pieces. I mean, every win is a puzzle. So we have different pieces, and we have important persons, and then, of course, we have different people, let's say, giving us a contribution. Now, because we're talking about important men for the wins, but also for the team spirit, I would like to invite the general director, Ducati Corse, or Ducati Racing. This is Gigi Dall'Igna.
Ciao, Gigi, ben ritrovato.
Gigi, nice to see you again. Okay, well, first of all, how are you? Okay, I'm fine, thank you. And I look forward to, well, starting with the new season. You know, this is such a thrilling moment in time, I mean, in our life, you know, because the presentation gives you this, you know, a euphoria, and then you are put to the test. You have the very first, you know, test bench, because, of course, we have to see what our competitors do. Before moving on, let me make a step backward. I mean, in terms of podium, so in terms of wins, this is the second best season inside MotoGP concerning, I mean, your team. So a great success. But what do you think about what happened? I mean, what's your feeling, well, having to do with the season that we have just concluded? Well, you know, we have just enjoyed the three incredible wins. So if someone tells me tomorrow something like your brain has depleted your memory, so you have to throw away something, well, I couldn't know what to do. I mean, I really would like to keep everything in my memory. You know, the first of Andrea in Qatar, now that was very difficult because there was, I mean, we were very nervous, you know, in the boxes, because I know that maybe our competitors would have, you know, claimed that we did something maybe not correct, and then all the way to Mugello with the three bikes, you know, full speed in the straight line, and then this incredible, you know, let's say speed up time at the San Donato corner, and then Andrea in Austria. So once again, he was so resolute. I mean, there was so much, let's say, determination, and so that day he said something like, "Today I will win," and he did. There's an incredible emotion in your eyes when you talk about these moments, and I'm sure that I mean, we would like to have many other, you know, such emotions and many other wins, maybe even more than this in the next season. So if we take into account, I mean, this new season and the new beginning, I'm sure there will be some novelties, new developments, maybe some changes. So what can we expect from the forthcoming season? Well, you're right. It will be, first of all, a complicated season because, of course, we have strong, difficult, hard competitors in terms of, you know, constructors, but also in terms of the riders. Well, I think that we did all what we could do. I mean, the bike was in the testing season in Valencia, soon at the, I mean, just after the last competition, the last race in 2019. Now, the chassis is usually different. This is something very different because, once again, we made plenty of changes to the key structure of the bike. And then the, let's say, the immediate, you know, feedback from the riders has been positive. And, of course, we will keep, you know, testing, and we will keep improving the chassis. Also, in terms of the... you know, the engine, plenty of important steps forward have been made. Once again, we had a prototype in the end of season testing, and we have just concluded, once again, the testing, let's say, season. So in the next engine, so that we will send, I mean, to Qatar and Sepang, there will be some new, let's say, changes. And of course, we will be even stronger. Even the fairing will be brand new. We will try it. We will test it in Sepang or Qatar. And I have to say that, of course, you know, regulations are so, let's say, binding. So it's really difficult, I mean, to let our fantasy fly high. Anyway, I'm sure that we did plenty of changes and improvements. Once again, I know we have improved. And now it all depends on what competitors managed to improve. So this is why the first test is so important. Well, we will find out in a while. Okay, so step by step, we will discover new developments and the new bike. Okay, it's not yet unveiling time, not yet. But I can, you know, tell you something about some details. We have some backstage clips and videos. You can see something very interesting together with, you know, the frantic, you know, attitude that's included into this beautiful world. Here we go. Time to show you our great riders. I mean, the real 2+2 for four wheels. They will color in red the racing tracks all over the world. Now, they are not here. So, of course, we cannot unveil the bikes if they are not here. So, once again, ladies and gentlemen, official riders, Andrea Dovizioso and Danilo Petrucci. Welcome, Andrea. Nice to see you again. Danilo, nice to see you. Okay, then, we have waited for a long time. So time has come to see what's, you know, under these red, you know, covers. Desmo Sedici GP 2020. Here we go. Mm-hmm. So two wonders, as you can see, are ready to get wins and conquer, you know, plenty of racing tracks. Well, you have to ride it quite often in the future. So why don't you just, you know, get familiar with the bike? Okay, let me start this short interview with Andrea Dovizioso. Third season, once again, you are the vice champion of the world. But after this, because we all know, I would like to know which kind of training you went through for the forthcoming season. Well, first of all, buonasera, good evening, everyone. I have to say that everything is going quite well. I started mid-December, so I have received a very specific program or plan, training plan for this year. And in 1 week, a little bit more than 1 week, we will fly to Malaysia so that we can really define the brand new material that we have just received. And I'm really ready. Now, people from home or maybe people here, they must have seen something different on your, what is it? Oh, I'm daunted. This is a very specific meaning. I'd like to have the translation of this word, or maybe the explanation of this word. Okay, I have changed some things. The number here, the name on the back, and even the helmet. Okay, once again, I'm daunted. I know that it is a very special word in English, and especially in Italian, but I really, really wanted to find an adjective, so a word that could really, really describe, you know, me and mirror my feelings. And my feelings are, I want to be focused on my objective. Well, you feel very resolute. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much, and good luck, Andrea. Big round of applause to Andrea Dovizioso. Thank you. Now, 2nd of June of 2019, back to rounds of applause. I can't imagine how many congratulations and compliments and, you know, how many hands have been, you know, shaken, because I've seen you at Mugello. You won there. It's a dream becoming reality, coming true, right? Absolutely. First of all, good evening, everyone. It was an incredible day. Well, let me tell you, an unforgettable day, June the 2nd, 2019. Once again, it was an incredible blend, a mix of emotions. And I'm sorry because I cannot remember some of those feelings, emotions, and things that happened that day. Anyway, that was a great win. I mean, I expected it. I mean, that was my target, my objective, but I didn't think I could do this at the Mugello. But I think, I mean, I have the, you know, chosen the right place to do this. Once again, that was absolutely incredible. I mean, terrific. I mean, the entire, you know, race and the entire day, by the way. You know, as soon as you win, you get, you know, off the podium, and then, you know, the feeling is I want to go back, you know, on the top level, and of course I want to go back to step number one. Of course I want to see you, I mean, on the highest, you know, step of the podium. Now, last season, also from your perspective, maybe was a little bit sort of an underperformance. Do you think you can do better? What about your training? Well, let's say that I had no, let's say, expectations, you know, at the beginning of the year. And then, you know, race after race, maybe there was a sort of an underperformance because I just didn't expect I could do that well. Now, I can't say that that was difficult, but let's say that I felt so motivated. I wanted to do more and more, and I made some mistakes. But once again, that was a lesson for me. So let's say I grew up a little bit. Let's say I don't have a specific objective. Let's say I want to do better than 2019. Thank you so much and congratulations. Enjoy the next season. Danilo Petrucci, thank you so much. Now, we talked about the bikes, we talked about, and we also talked to the riders. Now, let me invite the sport director, Ducati Racing, Paolo Ciabatti, together with team manager, Davide Tardozzi, and the tester, Michele Pirro.
Ciao Barbara.
Barbara, it's a pleasure to see you. Nice to see you too. Good evening, everyone. Okay, now that will be so short. Let me just tell you that it's a pleasure for me and for all of us to have all of you here, because we need you to start a thrilling season together. So we have very high expectations, and I'm sure we will offer passion to all of our Ducatistas. I mean, so all of the Ducati fans, thank you so much for being here, or you know, listening to us thanks to the streaming service that we have tonight. Now, this is a major engagement, commitment. I know it's difficult. It's going to be hard, but I'm sure we have the bikes, we have all the technology, and then, you know, we have the right brains and minds to get a good result. This is Davide Tardozzi now. This is one of the key members of my family, so to say. We met so many years ago, and Michele Piero, our, you know, tester, and without them, all of this wouldn't just be possible. Davide, just a couple of words with you on the season to come and on the, let's say, environment that we have built in and around our team. Well, I think that this environment is a positive one. It is part of the result. So, unquestionably, this is a fantastic environment. In the paddock, people tell us that we are a beautiful family. And I think that this is fundamental. I mean, the relationships that we have between, you know, the riders and even the, you know, self-esteem that everyone has. So, once again, we have friendship and we have great results. So, what we can do here is, you know, offering help. So, a technical help. We follow Gigi's, you know, directives, and I'm sure that this beautiful climate, I mean, this environment around us is absolutely positive and fundamental. So you test, Michele, you test the bikes before we give them to the official riders, and so you do, let's say, the dirty job, right? Just a couple of works on the G20. Good evening, everyone. Well, I have to say that the 2020 bike is a development. It's an evolution. It has received improvements in many different areas. And I'm sure that we have an incredible, well, engineering effort that was done to improve the bike. Once again, the objective is always the same, winning the world championship. And I'm sure friends here will make sure we also have fun. So I'm so proud that I am included into the big Ducati family. So once again, Andrea and Danilo, good luck and up with Ducati. Michele, thank you. Thank you so much. Okay then, so we have the energy, we have the passion, we have novelties, we have new developments, we have tangible results. So once again, we just look forward. So you know that the first rendezvous we have is in Qatar. It will be March the 8th, okay? So don't forget. This is it. I really would like to thank the protagonist of this beautiful presentation. Would like to thank you for making it here tonight in Bologna, and thank you to everyone, because I know that the streaming service has been delivered to the four corners of the world. We stop the streaming connection here. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Yeah,